Okay, put the camera down.
We had the team on.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was their first loss of the year, too.
Now, what about Liz, like Lisa?
You run, the water will get.
And I thought you was paying attention.
And I thought that we would do with the Judy Garrett. Get everyone to look.
Everybody, can everybody look at Maureen?
Good morning.
Can everybody look?
He's getting paid, architectural drawing.
Uncle Jack, turn around.
Tommy, you're making a habit now to send me these sort of.
No, over the camera over here.
When is the next one?
Hey, Sean, you hot in the butt?
I just do what he likes to do.
Take a shoot coming over.
Right.
It's all zeros and homework, say balance.
Well, he's very good at playing.
If you don't turn the homework with zero.
We're gonna get our own next one.
Well, I got involved in it.
This body's for you, we love you.
Salute.
Salute.
We'll talk later.
Chin chin.
He's gonna get a speech later.
Drink and then I'll talk a lot.
We just want.
The whole time he's zooming in on Janice.
Move along.
On Janice, on Joanne.
Remember that time?
No, you were zooming in on Janice the whole time on my first birthday.
Oh, that.
Remember the New Year when Billy was following you around with your hair?
Billy was there?
Yeah.
I hate seeing myself on video, especially like his profile, and I'm like, oh my god, I need a nose job.
Joanne's gonna be 30 in July.
I saw my friend's wedding video, and I'm like, oh my god, I need a nose job. And Bill's like, of course he's saying, oh, you don't need one. He's like, yeah, maybe you should get one.
Everybody wave.
That's what you focus in on when you look at yourself. Nobody else does. No, just one.
What are you telling us now?
I said, I hate seeing myself on video because I see my profile and I kind of know.
Janice, that's Janice.
As you get older, you learn.
The J is throwing her off.
When you're 50, you won't even think of that.
I'm like, how many are you gonna say?
Oh, no, you don't need a nose job.
He's like, yes, you can.
Let's get the profile. Wait, let's get a profile.
Honest and lie. When you think deep down inside, what?
Yeah, I'd rather he lie.
You would? And then deep down, I said, Jesus, I wish you could have gotten me a new job. No, honey, it's really.
That's loud Maureen speaking now.
That's love.
What, mine? It's love?
Maureen, when do you have your appearance to the winner's party?
Unless you.
Franklin.
At the Franklin.
Franklin Plaza.
Right across the street from the hospital.
The Franklin, that's where we'll have.
Franklin.
No, it was the Franklin. It was Wyndham.
The Wyndham Franklin.
Yeah, the Wyndham.
Wyndham, that's how it is.
It's the Wyndham Franklin Plaza. It is, we just stayed there in January.
That was my team, he's going like this to me. Yeah, I guess it's about a year ago, right?
Yeah, but I'm going with that, Andy. I think it's him.
You should say something. I said, he's thinking my husband. Say something.
Yeah.
We'll have it at the end of the world.
Okay.
It's moving around, make sure I get everyone. Everybody wave.
Let me reopen, you just for a minute.
I had a credit card for a help.
Congratulations, Bill.
Yeah, he's a lot of like chickens talking.
I appreciate it.
More.
Thank you.
How hard you work for
it. Hey, no, wait a minute. You're not my son if you have nothing else to say.
Pretty,
oh, I forgot. Judy.
The milkman.
It's okay.
How hard it works?
Trudy didn't shut up.
6 times?
I was telling Grandma and Grandpa about when I found out. Ed told me, that's why he's my...
Speak to the back of the room.
Oh, shut.
Project your voice. Project your voice.
Take it, Grandpa.
I was telling Grandma and Grandpa earlier how I found out and how Ed left me the voicemail. Hey, Bill, it's Ed. You passed. That's how I found out I passed CPA exam. No, wait, I forgot one thing. Hey, Bill, it's Ed. You passed. Congratulations. Click. That was my, like, that was how I found out. Dad had a, Dad had a sign above his house, and I had a voicemail from
you
Ed.
You had a sign when you came home?
You had a sign.
No, that's right. We both had a sign.
Me and Trudy were totally.
They worked very hard on that sign.
No, but that's how I found out. It was Ed's voice. First I heard Ed's voice, like, Bill, it's Ed. You got your CPA grades. You passed. Congratulations. Because when I first heard his voice was so loud. My heart sank when I first heard his voice, because I'm like, oh shit, he's like,
oh,
no, you got your brains, you passed.
Well, I thought he was not Eddie, but somebody died.
But, you know, whenever I got a voicemail from Eddie, it was, I don't know.
It was usually bad news, right?
Right, so that was my experience. It wasn't like you walking into a house at home. But...
Well, what about Jameson?
Yes.
Experience.
Jazz, speak on speaker.
No, you tell.
Oh, Janice.
Actually, she called me at work and said, oh, Bill, I passed. Did you find out yet?
So I'm saying, I mocked you.
Bill, guess what?
So my heart's in my... I'm like, oh, congratulations. I had to call home, but good. You tell.
What am I supposed to...
I found out.
I answered the phone. I was at work and I answered the phone. I always answer. Delight and Cheese, Janice Munt speaking. So I answered the phone. I said, Delight and Cheese, Janice Munt speaking. All of a sudden I just hear this like loud scream. And I'm like, oh my God, what is this? So I thought it was a fax machine. Did you ever like answer the phone where someone's faxing it? But it was my mom. She's like, oh my God, you passed. So I started screaming. I was at the a client, so I just shut the door and I just started screaming. I was hysterical. And then I had to call Bill, and I was like, oh my God, I didn't want to call him because I hadn't heard from him yet, so I didn't know. I didn't feel comfortable calling him because I wanted to find out.
Well, you did anyway.
But I called him. I'm like, Bill, guess what? I'm like, I passed. And then he hadn't heard out. He's like, well, I told him to call me if I passed.
Okay, that's
he hadn't heard. All right, up to bed. And then he called me back and he said he passed, so I shut the door again and I started screaming.
Aww.
Johnny Walker Black.
What they call him?
Let me just say that there aren't too many opportunities in a person's life that he has the good fortune of experiencing what we're experiencing tonight. That is our family, our extended family, Trudy's family, her sisters, my brother, my friends, and my children. Loving each other and congratulating one of our own, achieving a level that's important, CPA. Something I did myself. The reason this dinner is tonight is, to some degree, an expression of love for my father. Trudy and I, 2 weeks ago, saw the movie In the Name of the Father, which was a love story between a son and a father, around the concept of conflict in Ireland.
And
something we also understand and appreciate. I hate the fucking British. But in this way, many years ago, Ed Hackett, James Edward Hackett, whose name Edward Hackett, went to Pace College, put 2 years in and majored in accounting, graduated as accountant. He worked for the Japanese before the Second World War, helping them calculate the price of scrap iron.
I thought he worked in a towel factory.
No, which was being shipped back to Tokyo. But he was an accounting major, and he understood and appreciated the concept of being an accountant. So when I was lucky enough to get a partial scholarship at St. Peter's College to the School of Business from St. Peter's Prep. It wasn't an athletic scholarship, Tom. Unfortunately, Notre Dame didn't want me. They didn't appreciate my athletic ability. But
Notre Dame was your second choice.
Yeah, that's what we always
do. He was very proud of the fact that I worked in public accounting. And when I passed the exam, on the day, of course, I passed the exam, all you know the experience, I got a letter home. Trudy opened it. Said, I passed the exam. She put the sign on the door, James Hackett, certified public accountant. I came home from work. I think it was working with Ed Conway at American Insurance.
It was a Saturday.
Came home, opened the door, and here was a sign in front of me. It said, James Hackett, certified public accountant. And at that moment, this tremendous feeling came over me of relief. And this great weight lifted off my shoulders because it was something, one of the things I had always wished could occur, but always wondered whether I ever was good enough to become a CPA. And once that occurred, I sort of had a whole new view of life. And I often said afterwards, before I was a CPA, I knew all the answers. After I was a CPA, I knew all the effing answers. Sorry, I can't say in front of Mr. Plus. Now,
I heard this is a repeat speech.
You heard this speech before? After I passed the CPA exam, my father.
He took this out of the file. This is what he brought
who
up.
Who never really made an awful lot of money in his life, spent a lot of money, set up a great dinner.
Who spent money?
My father.
Papa. Papa.
At no. Sid Allen's.
He spent money on me.
at a restaurant called Sid Allen's in Englewood Cliffs, and invited a lot of the family and friends to celebrate the fact that I passed the CPA exam. I always remember that. I felt very pleased that my father had done that to me. And I guess in the back of my mind, I wondered whether at some point in time any of my children would pass the CPA exam.
At
now, I love all of my children.
What about the teachers?
Equally.
Now
we like to I love Kathleen.
Trudy's gonna
I love Jimmy. I love Maureen, who's my favorite.
We got it on tape, right?
Billy, Eileen, and Eddie. But when one of your children.
You forgot one.
He said you forgot.
I missed it.
Yeah. Kathleen, you are the first.
You're the oldest, you're the first.
Number one.
But one of your children sort of proceeds through life and does something that you did yourself, it's an extra special feeling, person. And when I identified Billy early in life
as a person who had the skills and the personality traits that would be very good as an accountant.
Oh my God.
Out of the womb.
At age
3, you're going to be a CPA.
Wait, was it Kyle version? Was he setting up?
No, it was like he's the captain, right?
No, it's because Billy used to find everything.
He was very organized,
always
knew what everyone else was doing, always was in control.
He knew where I put everything in the house.
Kept true
to the line. And those traits are analogous to someone who's a CPA and a controller and someone who's a strong accountant.
It's true.
So I directed him in my own way, subtly, through CPA and later to Scranton, to major in accounting, because I believed that he would maximize his ability in that profession.
So he had it all planned out.
So you had no choice.
No, not at all.
Believe me, my friends are agree with exactly what you said. Your father made you do this.
I was so pleased that he majored in accounting. I was pleased that he graduated and had very good marks at Scranton. I was very pleased that Deloitte, Haskins, and Sells was smart enough to hire him.
Don't help you.
A little bit,
not
much.
Deloitte Haskins. What's
it
gonna feel like to have a second child?
Dylan.
Is that gonna be even more of a...
Yeah, he'll get his own, but this is for Billy.
His time will come.
When he was hired by Deloitte and Touche, spent a couple of years there, I was very pleased. I recognized the fact that he might have a little trouble passing the CPA exam.
Because you did?
Yeah. I had a little trouble myself. And that ultimately he would pass it when he got to that serious level of concern that it was important for him.
Janice Munford. That was a serious
He was level. Very fortunate to meet Janice.
He would never pass.
At Deloitte and Touche. And their partnership relationship, I think, exaggerated his opportunity to pass the exam. He was helped by Janice, I'm sure, and vice versa, he helped Janice. But both of them as a team passed the exam in May of 1993. And at that moment, I was pleased beyond any feeling that anyone else could comprehend other than someone who was a CPA. I'm sure Tom understands what I'm talking about. When your own son passes the CPA exam, it's a special, special feeling because your son has reached a level that you consider very important in your own development. And what made it extra special was the fact that Janice, who has become a very good friend of our families, passed the exam at the same time. These two individuals who seem to love one another very much and compliment each other.
Lover?
Also have experienced professionally the same success. And it brings me back to the point that I really started this whole discussion on, which is honoring my father.
Oh,
I heard that too. Okay.
Oh,
you're
that.
My father was.
Stand up, man.
Bobby's ordering eggs for breakfast.
Want some pancakes?
Ready for the coffee? I'm sorry, Gary.
My father, in his own way, obliquely involved in my development because my mother was the strongest element in my life, was sort of honored very much when I passed the CPA exam. And in my own way, to respect him and what he did for me, I wanted to make sure that I did the same thing for my son. And hopefully, Billy will pick up that mantle, and someday, the fruit of those young kids' marriage down there may someday be a CPA himself.
Not even a glimmer yet.
That's true.
So tonight, we are all gathered together in a unique and wonderful dinner where family is important and friends are important. I've given you my point of view from Billy's standpoint, but at the same time, this dinner is equally important and for Janet's mom, who has, through a number of experiences in life, succeeded. And here is another success, passing the CPA exam. And with Billy, I would like to extend my toast to both of you in your success, and hope that that success will continue through your life and be the beacon for possible $200,000 to $300,000 a year.
Cheers.
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 Don't drink it. That's a good one. In nomine patris.
Attempt to secure your certificate to give these two fine representatives of the CPA profession tonight. However, I was told they were not yet printed. It appears that when they went back and they were putting the data together, there was a little bit of a problem with the name Hackett.
From past experience,
apparently Mr. James Hackett has not completed all of his continuing requirements. So I don't have your certificate tonight. I do have two of my. You pass it on, Jack, to the nominees.
Nominees.
Put these on. And let me, if I may just. What I normally do is I give a little speech to all of the candidates, and you know, they're sitting out in the audience, and you know, they're different backgrounds, ethnic backgrounds, Jewish and Polish and Indian and what have you. And let me just give you a little bit of the. Let me just give you a little bit of my speech and picture it as if it would be for all of the people who are becoming CPAs at the present time. This is really true. I want to thank you, Janet, who is the head of the State Board of Accountancy, and on behalf of the 13,000 members of the New Jersey Society of CPAs, I congratulate you candidates who tonight receive your certificates for successfully completing the examination. And this, I don't have to remind you, is a wonderful achievement. You worked very hard to achieve this success, and I hope you savor the moment and enjoy this evening. I know it certainly beats looking forward to another 4 months of constant study on the weekends like your baby brother is doing, even as we speak. And at the time, I also congratulate the candidates' guests tonight, because they always bring a spouse, parents, brothers, sisters, friends. And just remember, I say to all of them that you don't have to worry about preparing or paying to prepare your income tax return over ever again, because your new CPA takes on that responsibility. And that's a society rule, that if you're here tonight to join in the party,
sure, yeah.
You're entitled to some rewards.
Okay.
So even if your new CPA has the unmitigated gall to send you a nominal bill for preparing the return, look at the silver lining, it's tax deductible. But I wouldn't pay it. Now, when one of the parents in the audience tonight, and I was really looking forward to doing this, Mr. James Hackett, and that he would stand, you know, look very proud, and everybody would look, ooh, look at him. when Mr. Hackett and I passed the exam about 100 years ago, he was reputed to be the youngest person to have passed the uniform examination. That's what he told Mrs. Daly, in any event. And although it might seem so, this really was not a great achievement, because there were relatively few people who took the exam in the olden days. There were virtually no women. He used a quill pen. Now, and Janice, you'd appreciate this, now the majority entering the profession, and certainly the larger firms, the big six, are female. And that's only one change that's taking place in the profession. And what, and this gets to the serious part, maybe I'll just read this, but when at the ceremony that Jim and I received our certificates, the State Society gave each candidate a book on ethics, written by a great leader of our profession, John L. Carey. He was from Honolulu, I'm from Brooklyn. No relation. But I still have that book, and we don't give it to the candidates anymore. But the message has not changed. So I remind you, as incoming members of the profession, to remember how highly our profession, which is now your profession, values our professional standards and ethical conduct. It's really the cornerstone of our profession. We may make mistakes, but one thing, we always carry out our responsibilities with the highest professional and ethical standards. And that's why we all sleep so well at night. Especially after a long wintry night in frigid New Jersey. And then I finish by saying I'm very proud to be a CPA. We give out the buttons, proud of our profession, and proud of your achievement tonight. So I welcome Janice and Billy to the profession, and be proud to be a CPA. You've earned it, have a great career, and have a wonderful celebration tonight.
Thank you.
That's what this all started.
That's where we met. That's where we met. Up on Queen Lack.
I was sitting in breakfast. I mean, just with a piece of paper, say the edible and sat in front of it. And So a gorgeous doll come down the this hallway with a mother.
That's Mitch.
Well, I grew up with Jimmy for a second, and I loved all the family. Well, we both love all of our three daughters, three sons in law, 17 grandchildren.
Their wives,
how many
great-grandchildren?
25.
Two more get married.
I'm not going to guess how many.
12 great-grandchildren.
12, okay.
Sons and daughters-in-law, really, yeah. I have, and granddaughters, and some 12 great-grandchildren. I want to congratulate Janice out there.
To join the gang.
Getting her husband through the CPA. The examiners, see what you can do. That's the far we can run. But I understand that they give it 6 or 7 or 8 or 9 groups of questions for CPA. And Bill wanted to get the whole business because he gets the whole more questions than anybody else. Maybe Grandma. made a great grandmother. That's what you always say.
No, I you said it all.
Come on, Grandma, say something.
We're all just happy that every one of them is here and all well and healthy.
They give us the winning pencils for the Super Bowl.
That's what I should have had. I didn't have pencils with me.
We got Philadelphia Eagles.
I got the Cardinals.
Who else? Margaret.
And I got second.
She got second.
I had the
and Janine Buffalo and Margaret. They had the Cowboys.
Who won, Ma?
Who won the Super Bowl pencils?
Your sister. Margaret and
we just
Margaret
went through
and
that.
Janine, the first ones, and Ann had the second prize.
So
and Eddie had the booty prize.
Eddie got the booty prize.
I use it on wash.
I said to that, that's what they use.
That's $2.
You can get any wash, but you got $2 sent to a car.
You got what, Ken?
$2
the booby prize.
Okay, let me say one other thing.
Try for lunch, yeah.
I got it. Look, this is a special night for Bill and Janice. Particularly special because I'm a CPA and I like the fact that one of my children became a CPA. But my six children, I couldn't even attempt to sense of the six of them which one was more loved by me than any of them.
We all know.
Maureen.
But cats, she was your mother.
But each one of my children have been very successful in other areas, other than CPA. Kathleen, majored in finance at Catholic University, went on to Continental Insurance and is now the manager of investments at Continental Insurance. She was smart enough to tackle that Irish lover boy, Sean McCauley. My son Jimmy succeeded at Marist College, majored in business, was smart enough to grab Joanne as a wife and a wonderful companion, and has been very successful in the development of his economic situation, since I know it's actually in the financial area of the Merrill Lynch. Maureen Hackett.
Hey, Maureen.
The one with
I don't think we have enough time to listen.
The one with the big mouth.
Helen, like,
I wonder where Helen is.
Helen,
yeah.
The second. Has just recently successfully completed her Series 7's exam.
Cheers.
Which in the investment industry is the same as the CPA. Unfortunately, I don't have enough money to have a dinner for you today. Yes.
I have to
say that, all right? Just start now.
My special daughter, Eileen Hackett, is still matriculating. Matriculation is a bad word to understand when you are paying loans at Marywood College.
Someone hasn't been there in years.
However, I believe that she is focused on the career path for her life, and she has met and worked with and is happy with a very good friend, Brian.
Hi!
You got mentioned, Brian, who has left Molly Pitcher tonight early in order to come here. For some reason, I'm stuck. And that leads me with Eddie Hackett. My last son, Chuck.
Noser.
Who is currently being educated by the Jesuits.
S-J-U.
At St. Joseph's University, majoring in accounting. Although I've never seen a grade yet. He is very fortunate to have a friend and companion for the last 3 years and
but who's counting?
Adrian Sapino. That's the guy in last name. Who has exceeded Eddie in her athletic as well as academic abilities, and is now working among all those Jewish people over at the University of Pennsylvania. I believe Eddie, along with all my children, will continue to be positive and be success in life. But accounting and CPA is still ahead of you. And you have a great tradition to follow.
I think Kathleen should have gone first. Yeah. I didn't do anything. So what? You can still go for it. Maybe.
And the final analysis. This is a great evening for Billy and Janice. Janice, we love you and we respect you. It's very fortunate that Billy has been able to meet someone who is so beautiful, so bright, and so wonderful, all in the same person. And he's very lucky. Now we'll have dessert and coffee. Thank
you. And your wife, Judy.
To tell you how strong his influence is, while my oldest son John is in the Army, following my career path, his child Amy Hackett is at Mount St. Mary's College, majoring in accounting.
You have to have a dinner like this.
Exactly.
We're gonna have one for Eddie.
When Eddie and Amy do it. And my three children refer to Mr. and Mrs. Keegan as Grandpa and Grandma Keegan. And they are part of our
family. How do you spell Grandpa?
Family. And they are yours.
That's a Jersey City girl.
At Sid Allen's many years ago.
Oh, you were?
Kind of in the same role that you were.
No, in Adrian's role.
I did not pass the CPA, but I was.
You were the brother. You were like Adrian.
And I was invited as Jack's guest
like
to come to that dinner.
She was.
And it really impressed me that someone would do this for their son. And I kind of felt as proud of Jim, not as proud, but I'm sure a little way, as proud as his parents were. And I just want to tell you that being there at that dinner and you being here tonight, I think you're getting into a wonderful family. And I thank you, Jim, for having us here. We enjoyed coming up from Washington. We were very glad to be here for Bill and Janice. Congratulations.
The core of this family, the core of the whole family, is behind Trudy here. She can't speak in front of groups as well.
Get her up, she'll speak. So you all talk to her.
No, as well as she can speak in front of my family, Sean, my little boy, Megan, Kyle, Seamus, with Joanne and Jimmy. She is the best thing that ever happened to me. She's great. And thank you. And one last thing, other than Jim. Jim taught me how to be a man, how to speak up for myself, how to believe in myself. Yeah. I'm trying the best I can.
How to be a bullshit artist.
That's part of it.
No.
It's important. It's important.
I know. I know. I've got it too.
Marnie.
Does this look like I'm bullshitting right now?
No.
And the last thing I want to say is over here. Grandma and Grandpa.
This
could be a little secret, little speech then.
I didn't mean to ruin it.
And Grandpa can't hear him.
I bet you wish you had that one on tape.
While standing on the quay,
No matter where you roam, keep a watching child. You'll miss her when she's gone. Love her as in childhood, when feeble, old, and gray. For you'll never miss your mother's love till she's buried beneath the clay. And as the years grow onward, I settle down in life, and I met a fine young Irish girl, and I asked her to be my wife. And as the kids grew older, they played around my knee, and I teach them the very same lessons that my mother taught to me. A mother's love is a blessing, no matter where you go. Keep her love. You'll miss her when she's gone. Love her as in childhood. Don't be.